Let's bring in One Nation leader Pauline Hanson, now joins us from Scenic Rim in Queensland. Good to talk to you, Pauline. I want to get your thoughts on the Greens first, especially today. I mean, you think the issue of the war between Israel and Gaza, Anthony Albanese and Peter Dutton are actually at loggerheads over that. They have quite contrasting positions, yet they're both unified in their condemnation of the Greens' position and their activities. What are your thoughts?
It's good to see. They should be unified. The Greens' stunts that they pulled in the Senate, walking out of the Senate and they're saying what's happening in Palestine and the Gaza and all the rest of it, it's stunt. It really is a stunt. And even some of the Greens that have stood beside some of these protesters with the signs that they've put up there is appalling, Chris, absolutely appalling. And the fact is, they've having a go at Israel. Now, it's like genocide. Now they say that Palestine was attacked without acknowledging what happened to Israel on October the 7th. They're a bunch of ratbags as far as I'm concerned, what they stand for. I wish the public would have more of an understanding. They all think they're greenies. We're all greenies. We want to look after our environment by all means, but they go too far. And what their policies are not in keeping what is Australian, what is being patriotic, what is keeping us from being divisive. I just have no time for them whatsoever.
All right, I want to get on to the NDIS right now. This is a scandal, the amount of money that's been wasted, money that's supposed to go to people with disabilities and money that's come from hardworking taxpayers. But what astonishes me is Bill Shorten keeps saying he's shocked at how bad it is, give him a chance, he'll fix it. He's been in there for more than 2 years. Why hasn't he done more to catch the crooks and make the scheme less penetrable to all these fraudsters?
Chris, I've spoken about the NDIS and your program over the last how many years, and when I first got into Parliament, it was brought to my attention about the NDIS and what we were signing up to. I was appalled by it. I thought it was these parents that came to Parliament House with their children basically incapacitated, couldn't move. They were worried about their future. Once the parents were gone, how were these children going to be cared for? It's blown completely out of proportion. Here we have one psychologist said, years ago in the 80s, it was 3 in 100,000 children that had autism. Now it's 3 in 100. You've got parents lining up, have to wait 6 months to get in to see these psychologists, then to get on the NDIS scheme. It's a scam. Then you've got prisoners coming out of prison. One prisoner, 1.3 million. Another prisoner, 803,000. Another prisoner, $100,000. Oh, that's to take them shopping, take them to cinema, take them, fishing. And then you've got people who actually want to go to the gym or go to the movies. Well, we'll have a carer. We pay for that. There's scams going on as far as people building accommodation for NDIS and people buying cars, then paid off through the NDIS. And these are the client. These are the people that are supposed to be caring for them. It is such a scam, Chris.
It's got to be fixed up.
And it's not even means tested. People don't even know this. You've got multi-millionaires that are actually on this. And Bill Shorten told me, and so did Linda Reynolds, and so did Stuart Roberts, told me that they have to have agreement from all the states. What I found out, you don't have to. They're all scared to do anything about it because they'll lose the voters out there. It's become a political hotcake, and it's the taxpayers. Fancy paying people to go on bloody holidays. Fancy paying people to actually have cars bought for them. It's an absolute scam. Until you actually rake the people over the coals, and what my policy is, if you are caught ripping off the taxpayers of more than $5,000, you will be charged with a criminal offence and you will actually be wiped off being one of these people that can provide the services for NDIS. Get rid of them.
They've got to get a lot tougher. We're nearly out of time, Pauline, but just quickly, we didn't need the Australian Bureau of Statistics to tell us we're in a per capita recession, did we?
We've known that for a long time. I think in Queensland it's $19,000 per capita. We are in a recession, but we've only been propped up because the high immigration levels come to Australia. Wake up, people. Stop voting for the same old that you are actually destroying. Your way of life, your cost of living is escalating because you don't think what the policies are. Why keep voting for the same idiots all the time that we're getting a bigger mess year after year after year?
Thanks for joining us, Pauline. Pauline Hanson, they're live from Queensland. Yeah, if there was a cost of living crisis before the election 2 years ago, what are we in now?